Welcome. In this video, we are going to see how to convert data which is in rows like this to columns like this. Here is the input file. You can download it and follow along. Link is given in the description. Here, each three rows is actually a record. So there is a name, there is a number, there is a date. Again, name, number, date. So I want it in three columns. This is the input data. It is a table. Name of the table is table 1, and all the data is in a single column. The name of the column is data. So let's close this file, open a blank new file and import it in Power Query. So data, get data from file, Excel, and select the file. Here we will select the table and we want to work on it. So click transform. The Power Query window opens and shows the original data. Let's follow this step by step. We want to create some additional columns here. So first let's go to add column and add a simple index column. It's like a serial number. Index column can be added from 0 or 1. I'm going to choose 0. Now we need to add one more column where we will say row numbers. So first 3 are row number 1. Second 3 are row number 2, like that. So let's add a custom column. We're going to use it for identifying rows. So I'll give it a name row. You need not change it. Just for easier explanation, I am changing this name. Now we need to add a function which will divide whatever is in the index column by 3, because we have sets of 3 rows. The function is called number dot integer divide. And then what do you want to divide, which is the index column, and what number do you want to divide it by? In this case, 3. In case in your data we have sets of 4 rows for every record, change the number. Now click OK. This indicates this is row number 0, 1, 2. Now we need another similar column to identify column numbers. So we want this to go in column 1, this to go in column 2, this to go in column 3. So let's add another custom column. And this time we will call it column. This time also we want to divide, but we want to do a mod. So number dot mod. This takes multiple parameters. What do you want to divide? Index. And what do you want to divide by? The same number, 3. So now you'll notice the row column is telling us this is row number 1, row number 2, and so on. And this one is telling me column numbers. Column number 0, 1, 2. And we have only 3 columns, so they are repeating. So far, so good. Now this index column has served its purpose. So let's get rid of it. Right click, remove. Now we want to do something like a pivot table here. So select the column, and then go to transform, pivot column. And now values will come from the data column, and we don't want any aggregation. So open the advanced thing and say don't aggregate. And that's it. We got exactly what we wanted. Few more steps to go. This one is no longer needed, so right click and remove. You'll notice that the data types are ABC 1 to 3. That means data types have not yet been detected. We want to do it for all the columns, so Control A to select all. Then go to transform, detect data types. Now it understood this is text, this is number, this is date. The only thing left to be done now is give column names, because in our data there were no column names, so it has just given 0, 1, 2. Double click and give the correct column name. That completes our procedure. So let's go to the home tab, load, close and load 2. If this was very large data, I would have added it to data model, but in this case it's a simple small demo. I'm going to choose table. Click OK, and we got cleaned data converted from rows to columns. The next thing is, let's add a couple of more rows of data and see if the refresh works. So I've added 2 more records. Save the file, close the file, come back to our data, right click, refresh, and it should add the 2 rows. So that is how you convert data from rows to columns in a structured manner using Power Query. If you find this useful, you already know what to do. Share it with as many people as you can. Like, subscribe, click on the bell icon, and give me ideas for more videos. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.